December 16th marks the day that Hitler attempted to punch a hole through the Allied lines and reclaim what he lost. The initial attack was swift and effective due to the heavy training and preparations made by the German army leading up to this offensive, ensuring Hitler's troops were prepared for what the Allies would throw at them. After a final meal, they set out to accomplish their mission. American response was swift. The 101st Airborne Division will be sent to the front to halt the German advance. Today we can be seen following the division's 801st Ordnance Maintenance Company as they prepare to embark for Bastogne. These men have spent the last number of days restlessly working on firearms big and small, performing repairs, cleaning, and re-outfitting to ensure every man could rely on their weapon to get the job done. They load everything they will need and more to bolster the division's strength into army trucks and jeeps. This includes small arms, ammunition, artillery elements, as well as equipment to make any necessary repairs, after which time they begin to prepare boarding the vehicles and disembark for the small Belgian town. Their convoy would consist of 80 vehicles made up of CCKWs, weapons carriers, jeeps, and more, taking them all through France and into Belgium where the rest of the 101st had arrived days prior. They would be merely 5 miles outside of Bastogne when disaster would strike. On December 19th at 2000 hours, the 801st Ordnance Company was caught up in the German army's encirclement of Bastogne, being blasted with artillery and forced to scatter for a chance to survive. All the way into the next day, they would make their way through Belgium trying to reorganize. The 801st would lose a considerable amount of vehicles and equipment in their hasty retreat, eventually managing to regroup and make their way to Neufchâteau and remain connected to the 8th Corps until the breakthrough. In the meantime, the rest of the 101st would be cut off and surrounded by German troops trying to take Bastogne. With the winter beginning to bring in its first snowfall, the German forces would be greatly delayed and forced into a standstill with the Allied lines. This would mark the last major German offensive on the Western Front for the remainder of the war, being forced into an all-out retreat back into Germany in the following months. A once mighty and formidable force brought to its knees in the combined efforts of the rest of the world.
Everyone was gay, singing songs of piccadilly.